pretty.
I'll be like, well, I met Matt Smith, peasant.
He's my friend.
Refreshments. I feel like I need some food, otherwise I cannot move around.
Brisbane, please put your hands together for Alex Kingston and Freema Ajman. Video for you, Alex.
A video?
We do.
Sorry.
I was going to start by saying hello, sweetie, but I'm so fed up of hearing that, or maybe you're not. So I will just say happy Mother's Day to you, Alex.
Oh my God.
I've only just met you, but I can tell within an instant what a warm, and kind and thoughtful person you are, and they are wonderful qualities in a mother, and your daughter is a very lucky daughter. She's also very considerate and loving, because she has organised all this for you to say how much she loves you. So I am passing love through me from her to you, and once again, happy Mother's Day. All the best.
Happy Mother's Day!
And set all this up for you, and we all adore you, and we love you, and you're probably the sexiest mum I know.
Oh, the people
your character in a song will make an appearance with the 12th Doctor?
I would like that very much. I think I'd give him a run for his money. yes, I mean, in a way, because all the Doctors are one and the same, I think it would be nevertheless really interesting to work alongside Peter, because he has brought a different facet to this Gallifreyan being. certainly there's a darker side to him, which I think would be quite interesting to explore. But I've had such a great time working with Matt and with David at the beginning that I think for me, and probably with any companion who transitions, I mean, I don't know about Jenna, I haven't asked her, but it must be quite difficult to transition and connect to a different external being, even though the actual character is the same person. So that's a question actually that I'd like to ask one of the companions who's done that. But I would, yes.
I'm going to pop up.
Get down.
One take, everyone.
Yeah, ready? Tennant Piper. Hello.
Now, Brisbane, give him a proper welcome.
Hi, I'm Isabel Schaefer, and my
Hi, Isabel
Schaefer. Hi. My question is, do you think the Doctor will regenerate as a girl?
Well, I think it's a very good question. I think we should all, however staunch we are, steeped in the history of the show, remain open to the idea that she could exist somewhere. Yeah, I mean, why not? Why not? Do I think it's going to happen anytime soon? I don't know. It's a tough one. I think we'll have a ginger Doctor before we have a female Doctor. Or maybe we just have a ginger female Doctor. I mean, who knows? I think absolutely, why not? I think it would be quite cool. But do you think so? Do you think?
Yeah, I think it was were boys and the Master turned into a girl.
Exactly.
I don't know why the Doctor couldn't.
Yeah, I agree with you. So, I mean, watch this space. Who knows? Anything can happen in this show. Good question.
Hi, this way. Sorry, that doesn't help. Your left.
Hello, I got you.
Hello, I'm good. I was just wondering, as a fellow terrible bowler, after watching your bowling match with the Doctor Who team versus the Nerdist team, if there were ever any rematches, or if you have plans to just practice on your own, get really good, and then challenge to a rematch?
I'd rather stick pins in my eyes. What a ridiculous sport. Tell you what, what do you want to do this Friday? Let's go bowling. Do you know what? Let's not. That is that of all people in the whole world to beat me at anything, Karen, how can Karen beat me at any sporting event? She's built like a twig. No immediate plans to conquer the bowling world,
Hi, my name is Thomas Schaefer.
Hi, Thomas. Hello. You're the brother of Isabel, aren't you?
Yes, I am. I plan on being the 15th Doctor. My mum and I have done the calculations.
Yeah. Works for me.
How can I get there?
Good question. Well, I think... I don't know. I think... How old are you? 14. So, listen, you better not do it before you're the age of 26, because I'll lose all my records. So wait till you're 27. I think, my friend, just plug away at being sort of slightly peculiar, not really fitting in, you know, develop some sort of strain of madness, and you're halfway there.
And as the Doctor after David Tennant, when he was so popular and so loved.
Yeah, yeah, of course, because everyone hated me before I'd even said a word. Do you know what I mean? I'd walk down the street and get booed. So it was difficult, and I think it was difficult for Stephen as well, with Russell and for Karen, but what that gave us was a real sort of spirit of camaraderie amongst our small group of people who were the new guys, as it were, and that was, you know, that was also really rewarding when it came out. It did quite well in England, and yeah, here we are now today. But it was, but yeah, it was a strange first couple of months. It's quite a, you know, it's a beloved show, and you don't want to be the person who breaks Doctor Who. Hey.
Yeah. Hello.
Hey, buddy.
When you were little, if you enjoyed Doctor Who and liked it, who would have been your favourite Doctor?
When I was little? The thing is, right, when I was your age, it wasn't on the TV. It's what I call the barren years. They took it off. Because they were idiots. I never got that wonderful experience. I mean, I don't know what it must be like as a kid to be like sort of scared and enthralled and at exactly the same time, which is what I think Doctor Who does. But I really like Patrick Troughton, but again, he was before my time. Yeah, a single round of applause then. I'm with you there, I think. And but I suppose the first Doctors I came to were Chris and David, really.